Welcome to Reading Rockets Pop Warner A Football. This is Josh Blumenschein on play-by-play with Adam Hooker on camera. The Reading Rockets come out here today with a 4-3 record after the forfeit loss to Acton-Boxborough. They're playing a decent Wilmington team today in the last game of the regular season, and the stakes are high for the Reading Rockets. If they win, they advance to the playoffs. If they lose, they're out of the playoff picture. Of course, our Reading Rockets have been hurt by injuries the last couple weeks, but the very heartening situation is that Brendan DeSilva, the quarterback, is back today. And you can see he's out to take the coin toss today for Reading Rockets. The Rockets will have won the coin toss. They defer. I'm sorry, no, the Wilmington defers. And so Brendan will take the ball. We're going from right to left on your screen. Dan McGrath with the injured ribs, he's back healthy today too. So your injury report, Colin DuRoss still has his foot in a boot, number 22. Jason Conroy, 44, and Jack Blumenschein, number 73, are both out with concussion symptoms, at least for another week. So you can see the Reading Rockets, they're pumped up today. They're ready to play under the direction of Coach Geiger. And we're here for, it's November 1st. It's cloudy skies, but temperatures in the low 50s, so very seasonable. So Reading Rockets will kick off from right to left on your screen. Christian Charger, number 43. There have been quite a few onside kicks they've recovered this year. You can see they stack six returners on the left-hand side. The ball's on the ground.
What a kick. That's a great kick.
It's right there. Oh, he can't handle it. Rockets are still there, and they fall on the ball. Is that Panucci, number 8? The Reading Rockets get the ball at the 38. Wilmington was very passive in trying to cover that onside kick. There were Rockets all over the ball. Great kick by Christian Charger. It took the nice bounce. And so the Rockets will start with the ball going from the 38 of Wilmington. Rockets open play with number 50, Matt Hammond, out right as split end. You've got 12 McGrath and 8 Panucci in the backfield. And McGrath takes it and goes over the right tackle. Stiff arms one man, gets to the outside. He runs through a tackler for a positive gain on first down of about 7 to 8 yards. Nice aggressive run by Dan McGrath there. Second and 3 Rockets, Jared Panucci in with the play call. As the season has gone on, he's had the ball more and more in his hands. Number 8, Chris Julie on the line at center with the snap. Panucci takes it over right tackle, follows Dan McGrath's block. He's able to push the pile a little bit, maybe get 2 yards on the play. He'll set up a third and short, maybe third and 1 or 2. Ready, breaks the huddle. Number 32, left guard, that's Dom DiCrescenzo. Panucci takes, no, McGrath takes a snap, runs around left end. He's looking to get to the outside, and he's met there. He is not going to make it. So that's going to bring up 4th and 6 as he lost 3 yards on the play. Blocking was not there on the left side. 4-down territory for the Rockets as they're going to try and make this first down on the play. From the 34, 4th and 6. Right now, left guard Lucas Lorenza. Left tackle Zach Barbo. The snap. Oh, wait. He's going to throw. He's got a man. Nope. It's intercepted. And brought down by number 9, Evan Long. So Wilmington takes over at the 25-yard line. Dan McGrath faked the run. Wilmington didn't bite. And they were there for the play-action pass. So Wilmington's first offensive possession. In the A-gaps, you've got 14, Vinny Sullivan, and 40, Thomas Keene. There's a jump by BJ, offsides. Didn't really give him a chance to get back, I thought, before the snap, but maybe there was contact. So it'll be 1st and 5 for Wilmington. this first drive in the B gaps, you've got BJ number 7, Gemellaro, and 32 Don DiCrescenzo. There's the handoff to the deep back. He cuts it outside, number 42. He's met there by Jared Panucci with a good tackle. Brings him down just short of the first down yardage at the 35. Second and one. The outside defensive ends, you've got Jay Kajander and Evan Long. Some of the assorted youth fans here that sometimes get on the field, making sure that they get off of the field. Maybe that means we'll have a good officiating crew today, I hope.
Absolutely. All in the name of safety.
Second and one for Wilmington. Wilmington in I formation. Pitch left to number 42. He's met there by Evan Long. He wheels him down, but across the 36-yard line, which will probably give him first down yardage. Nice tackle by Evan Long. First and 10 for Wilmington at the 37-yard line. There's a snap, the pitch to the right. Number 42's outside. He's gonna make first down yardage. Grab about 14 yards just over midfield. Before being hauled down, I think it was Dan McGrath on the tackle. Looks like number 42 is gonna do most of the ball carrying for Wilmington.
So far they've had couple plays outside. We're going to still the
ends. Sweep right, sweep left. New deep back now, number 25. Number 7, the quarterback under center. Really conventional. There he goes. There's initial push up the middle, and he is met hard.
Nice.
Brendan De Silva in there on the tackle. And a minimal pickup of about a half a yard on the play. That was a plunge right up the middle. More of a twin set backfield now. Still under center for number 7. He hands it to the second man through the hole on the left-hand side. Brought down, but after a strong pickup of about 6 or 7 yards. That was number 33 for Wilmington. I'll bring up third and 3. Oh, the quarterback keeper, he's met hard. He was a little pensive going up the middle there, and he'll remember that hit. That was De Silva on the play, I think, and also Ben Mason.
Wow.
Fourth down and 3.
They give him a pickup of 2 on that.
Wow, that's a generous spot. From the 41-yard line, we got a fourth down play here, fourth and just under 2 yards. They might want to think twice about doing that quarterback sneak again. Number 7 under center. He's going to pitch right.
Oh,
Jay's out there. And he's met Ben Mason with a crushing hit. The ball's on the ground. It doesn't matter anyway. Rockets ball. From their own 42-yard line. As Redding comes to the line here, we've got Brendan De Silva on offense, but he's the right wing. That's not usually where he plays. It's a Rhino offense. I think we got Ben Mason in the backfield with Dan McGrath. The snap goes to Mason. He's going to follow a convoy on the right side. He breaks through. He's got first down yardage and more. Outruns one man, number 42, all the way down to the 20. A 38-yard pickup for Ben Mason on first down. In the open field, he's hard to bring down with a head of steam.
Yeah. He's got speed for a guy his size, too.
He sure does. Rockets come to the line with Evan Long and Dan McGrath in the backfield. Christian Trauger split out wide left. There's the snap to Dan McGrath. He's got good blocking in front of him. He's able to pick his way through down over the 10-yard line, down to the 8. That's another first down carry for the Rockets. Excellent blocking over the left side that time. You got Matt Gorman, number 23, on the left wing right now, next to Zach Barbo. The snap to Dan McGrath. He's going over the right side. He's picking his way, and he's able to get down to about the 3. Waiting for his blocks to materialize. Second down.
That's the area of the field. You just want to give it to McGrath or Mason and just let them push it right through.
That's right. I like that Rhino formation that we had for the first play where you get two big blockers in front of the ball carrier.
Yeah.
And here we go. Mason's in the backfield with McGrath and Long. Who's going to get the ball? Snap goes to Ben Mason over the right side, right over right guard. He barrels in for the touchdown. Rockets on the board first with 2 minutes remaining in the first quarter. It's 6-0 Reading Rockets.
Benny, can't you see?
I think Coach must have heard us call for it.
Not a whole lot of luck stopping that today.
Blocking by that Reading offensive line throughout that whole drive. So Christian Chauger here to kick the extra point. He's got it up. Had the distance.
Good.
It is good. A two-pointer for Christian Chauger makes it 8-0 Reading. Reading Rockets to kick off here late first quarter. Christian Trauger, will there be another onside kick attempt? He boots it on the ground. It goes past 10 yards. Ball's on the ground. Reading looks like they have it again on the 47. You bet.
And they do. Panucci again.
They need the hands team on Wilmington. They need to work on that one. Trauger's getting some beautiful onside kicks, going just over 10 yards. Here comes Reading to work here on the 46-yard line after recovering that onside kick. Got Mason in the backfield here with the Panucci. Matt Hammond split out wide right. Wilmington defenders, they're looking kind of tired. Here goes Ben Mason over the right side. There's a nice tackle there by, he just wouldn't let go. He grabbed him around the middle, number 50 for Wilmington. Able to drag him down, no gain. Second down, Reading. So that last play by Ben Mason was the last play of the first quarter. We start the second quarter going from left to right. De Silva in the backfield right now. Second and 11. He takes the ball, fakes to McGrath, follows over the right-hand side. He's able to dive forward for 10 yards on second down. So that brings up third and one from the 38 is the spot. Third and two, actually. De Silva in the game, their playbook gets a little larger. There's more that they can do. There's a nifty little play there with a fake handoff to Dan McGrath. They spread the receivers on this play. Two right, two left. McGrath takes the handoff. He goes over the right-hand side. He's met there. He's able to drag forward just to the original line of scrimmage. So that brings up fourth and two from the 38. I got to say, love Dan McGrath as a player. He's not running with the same speed and power today. He had those bruised ribs in the last game.
Yeah, Yeah, it's going to take a little time to recover. But kid likes to fight. He's out here.
He'll be fine. Yeah. He'll be fine. Fourth and three right now. De Silva in with the play call. Got Panucci and Hammond to the left. Mason and Long to the right. McGrath and De Silva in the backfield. There's a snap. Brendan throws it up, and it's intercepted by number 25. He evades one tackler, and he runs out of bounds at the 39-yard line. So Wilmington ball at the 39. Pass hung up a little bit too long, didn't quite make it to Ben, who was deeper than that, Ben Mason. First and 10 from the 39. Wilmington comes to the line of scrimmage in the I formation. Tailback is 7 yards deep. Number 12, he rolls out to throw. He puts it up. He's got a man, number 7. He's got first down yardage. He's pushed out by Jared Panucci at the 41. Nice little play design, the bootleg throw. He found a man wide open. Under center, whoa. First 10, he takes the sweep out to the left. He gets around Jake Kajander, but he's got Trevor Zupan there. Knocks him out of bounds, no gain. Number 65, Trevor Zupan was there and was able to make the play. There's a flag down. That's what the call is. We've got a hold on Wilmington. Coach elects to push him back, so that'll make it first and 20. First and 20, Wilmington, from their own 47-yard line. We had some movement on the line. That's what they call. We got a false start on Wilmington.
Going the wrong way right now.
First and 25 for Wilmington. Penalties taking them the wrong direction. There's the snap. The handoff to the second man over the right-hand side. Not going to get much on that one. A horde of tacklers. He's down after about a 2-yard gain. Second and 23. They spread the receivers. They've got trips right, but then they, yeah, three receivers to the right. One back in the backfield. The pass, the little bubble screen. Number 12 throws it up, and he finds a man. Gets past Zupan. He's got first down and more. Number 22. He's dragged down by B.J. Gemellaro at the 15-yard line. That was a backwards lateral to the deep receiver on the right, who then quickly threw the ball as he was getting hit down the middle of the field. He got a man and a nice pickup for Wilmington. First down. This Wilmington team has a few tricks up their
Absolutely.
Sleeve.
Absolutely.
So far, Redding's punched him in the mouth, but they've been able to kind of hang on, and they're still in this football game.
That's one of those games where been a lot of talk all week. You just want to go out and do the job.
Redding may be showing a little bit of rust after a week off. Number 12 under center, two backs behind him in an I formation. The snap, the pitch to the right, number 7 looking to get outside. He's dragged down by Brendan De Silva, and Jared Panucci helps finish him off. Little gain on the play, second down. Yeah. Reading tends to have pretty sure tackling. Good to have Brendan back in the defensive lineup. Second and 10. There's the handoff to number 42. He makes a spin in the hole. He gets a good pickup of about 5 or 6 on the carry before he's finished off. That'll bring up third down. Into the A gaps. Off comes Barbeau and Lorenza. Third and 4. Here's the pass. He's got a man. He doesn't see the ball. Ooh. He stepped back. He threw that pass before anyone was even looking. And the receiver never got his head around for the ball, so it falls harmlessly. Fourth down, big opportunity right here for the Rockets to stop. They've got a hold right here. Fourth and 4. Timeout, Rockets. Handle their assignments like you talk about, assignment football. Know your man and make that play.
All right.
Here we go. Fourth and about 3.5 for Wilmington. There's the snap. He's rolling out to pass. Number 12. He's met there by Ben Mason, and it's intercepted. Off to the races. That's Evan Long. He's running away. No one's going to catch him. He is in for the touchdown. Reading Rockets score on the fourth down interception. An ill-advised throw by the quarterback as he was getting sacked by Ben Mason. The only man there was Evan Long, who takes it the length.
Nice play.
But he scored 3 different ways. He scored running it on a kickoff return touchdown, I think, or punt return touchdown. No, fumble return touchdown, and then an interception return. Christian Trager for the extra point try. We had movement on the line. Hard to see if that was, that was encroachment by the defense. Yeah, so we'll move a little bit closer. Half the distance to the goal line. Extra point by Christian Trager is up. He's got the distance. Is it through?
Good, yeah.
It's good. 16-0, Reading Rockets. Clock shows 4.5 minutes remaining in the first half, as Reading has jumped out to a sturdy 16-point lead. Well, as Reading lines up for its third kickoff attempt of the first half, the first two both resulted in successful onside kicks. This time they're lining up a little different, 5 each side of Christian. I would imagine he's going to kick away. He boots it over to the right side, takes a bounce and gets past 25. Being chased there by Evan Long, he brings him down at the 25-yard line.
Boy, Evan's everywhere today.
He is flying around that football. You know, he's a good basketball player too, Evan Long.
Yeah.
First and 10, Wilmington, 16-0. Backs to either side of number 12 in the shotgun formation this time. There's the snap, he's back to throw. Good coverage out there. He completes it to 84 over the middle, brought down by Brendan De Silva at the 37-yard line. Kid's got a good arm.
Yeah.
Wilmington's moved it a little bit today, but to not able to get any points on the board. Got Trevor Zupan out here on the right tackle. See if he can get a little pressure. It looks like they're in passing mode right now. Jake Ajander, number 64, out here as well. He's rushing the quarterback effectively. He's on the way. Number 12 takes it himself up the middle. He's met there by, looks like, Vinny Sullivan and brought down after a gain of four. A flag is thrown. There's a little bit of a scrum here in the middle. We've got a personal foul on Redding. Don't need any of that.
I think it's one of those where they got the second guy. You just can't retaliate.
Yeah. The clock, first and 10 now at the 43-yard line of Redding. In the shotgun, number 12 is back to throw. He's got a pass up. It's caught by number 50. Panucci pushes him out of bounds at the 32 after first down yardage. There's a nice out route there to number 50. Well thrown, delivered on time by the quarterback. This quarterback is impressive for Wilmington.
Gotta get some pressure on him, make him move his feet.
We have not had that much pressure except for the interception.
Right.
Those quarterbacks this level, if you get in their face, you cause them to make bad decisions with the ball. First and 10. Still in the shotgun formation. There's the snap. He sets up the throw. It's a nice catch by number seven. De Silva takes him down after about a 5-yard pickup. Pass was slightly behind him, made a one-handed grab. Clock shows 3 minutes remaining. Coach calls a timeout to discuss the defensive alignment. Second and 6 for Wilmington. The snap is high, 12 handles it. He's got a throw, he's got a man, number 50, off his hands. Brings up third down and 6. Third and 6 for Wilmington. They try and get something going before the end of the half. Passing defense is being tested. 12's got time to throw. He gets it off number 84. Zupan drives him down, makes a nice tackle. It appears to be short of first down yardage.
It's like timeout Wilmington.
Timeout Wilmington. They've got a fourth down play coming up here with about 2 yards to go to continue their drive. This is from the 23-yard line. Wilmington, after the timeout, comes out with number 12 under center, two backs in the I formation. They've gotten away from the run game. He's rolling out to pass. He puts it up there. There's coverage, and it's knocked away by Dan McGrath. Beautiful coverage on the play, although the guy had gotten behind a little bit, but he's there to break it up, and Redding will take over.
Big stop.
First and 10 Rockets from the 23 after stopping them on downs. McGrath in the backfield with De Silva. There's the snap. McGrath takes it himself up the middle, cuts it to the right-hand side, able to get over.
The ball's loose.
The ball's on the ground. A Rocket was there.
I think he may have been down. No.
Ben Mason was able to recover the fumble at the 28-yard line, 29. So on the play, he picked up 6 yards. Rockets spread the formation here on second down. De Silva's got it. He's back to pass. He's got Dan McGrath. And it's There was a jump ball competition with number 25. Dan had his hands on it, couldn't bring it down. Bring up third down. Not a bad play call, though. Third and four, Reading Rockets. There's a snap, fakes the pass, runs it up the middle. He spun down there after a pickup of about three, close to first down yardage. Looks like it's probably, yeah, they're going to give him the first down as he gets out to the 34-yard line. First and 10, Reading Rockets from the 34-yard line. Clock reads 2:23. Not sure if you can trust that. Evan Long in the backfield with Dan McGrath. And the end around to B.J. Jemelar, who's got one man to meet. Boy, number 7 for Wilmington made a nice play out there. B.J. gets past him. He's got room to run. He held his ground and was able to make the tackle. Second down, Reading. It's a nice play.
Stayed at home.
Second 11 Rockets. Wind picks up here late in the first half. Snapped it to Silva. He rolls to his right. Gets a block from Dan McGrath. He's brought down at the 34-yard line, about the line of scrimmage. Third down Rockets. One more chance here. I imagine they would punt it away if they don't get first down yardage here. They quickly line up. Looks like Coach spends his last time out here. No, this is the end of the first half.
Yep.
So the half ends with the Reading Rockets up 16-0. Good effort by the Rockets. They're going to get the ball first in the second half.
Yeah.
So this is where you want to not mess around and, you know, step on their throat right away, get that extra score, make it a 3-score game, make it really hard for Wilmington to come back.
I think this is where you just put your biggest lineup in and run it right down the throat. They've not been able to stop you so far today.
One of those drives that takes up, most of a quarter.
Yeah.
Multiple first downs.
Just kind of break their will right off the bat.
We get started for the second half with the Rockets holding a 16-0 lead. They're going to receive the opening kickoff from number 12 on Wilmington. Is that right?
Yep.
No, maybe not. Maybe they don't have a kicker. Oh, yeah, number 12 is going to kick it. Ray's got a good hands team up front there. And the ball falls off the tee.
Been that kind of day for Wilmington so far.
Second try this again. It is an onside kick, and it's caught there by Ben Mason, gets right down. That is what Wilmington is not doing, catching those onside kicks aggressively inside of 10 yards. Yeah. Nice play. Reading will take over at the 49-yard line of Wilmington. So the first drive of the second half, you see Dan McGrath and Evan Long in the backfield. Christian Charger is the wide receiver, split out wide right. There's the snap. Over the right side, Dan McGrath bounces to the outside. He finds room. He's able to stiff arm one man, fight through three guys and carry another two all the way down to the 35-yard line for first down yardage, about 14-yard pickup. He just would not go down on that run.
He looked like Gronk Thursday night, carrying defenders.
Clearly, you can't tackle Dan McGrath high.
No.
Got Zach Barbo and BJ Jemilaro on the left side, along with Lucas Lorenza, number 24, the left tight end. There's a snap over the right tackle. Da Silva pushes the pile. He's able to get a yard or two. The Wilmington left side of their line got a stout push on that play. Second and 9 for the Rockets as Dan McGrath's in with the play, number 12. Keeping the ball on the ground is probably the best policy here for the Rockets. In the backfield now is the Rhino package. 54 Ben Mason's back there with McGrath and BJ. No, Evan Long. And Ben Mason takes the ball, busts over right tackle. He's able to get first down yardage and more, down to the 21-yard line for finally being upended. The blocking was solid, a huge hole created. Ben followed his blockers. First down, Rockets. First and 10 Rockets from the 22-yard line. Evan Long in the backfield with Brendan Da Silva. Redding using a host of different ball carriers. This time it's Brendan. He cuts it up off the left tackle and then cuts it up towards the middle. He's able to get a solid pickup of 9 or 10 on first down. He has a knack of accelerating through those holes.
Yeah. I would say he's very patient.
Yeah.
You know, finds his hole and just.
He sees it and then he's through it like a flash. Second and 1. The snap to Evan Long. He follows the block over the left-hand side, makes a move or two. He's able to avoid a couple arm tackles, get all the way down to the 5-yard line. First down carry for Evan Long. Looked like that was maybe going to be bottled up at the line of scrimmage, and he was able to get through for a first down.
A couple nice moves. We got a flag on the play.
Did I get in the way of your camera?
No.
A holding penalty by Redding negates that last positive carry by Evan Long. Makes it second and 11 from the 23. Right now we got Matt Gorman at left tackle, number 23. Zach Barbo, number 70, left guard. Of course, Chris Truly snapping the ball right now to Dan McGrath. Mason takes the snap, follows Dan McGrath over the right-hand side. The ball's on the ground. It looks like Wilmington has the ball at the 20. You know, I don't think Ben ever had a clean handle on that ball when he received the snap. He was trying to run, but he didn't have it really properly tucked away.
That's a tough turnover. We were moving down the field.
Yeah, moving towards the score, no doubt. You know, followed by the holding penalty, followed by the fumble.
Yeah.
Just shot that one in the foot.
Can't beat yourself.
First and 10 from the 21. Wilmington has a trips right formation, three receivers. Last time they threw out of this formation, number 12 takes it and hands off over the left-hand side. Ball carrier fighting for more. He's dragging the pile and gets 8 yards on first down.
Tough run.
Wilmington's not dead yet.
No. Plenty of time.
Second and 2. It's gotten a touch cooler, a touch windier here. Under center, number 12. Wilmington quarterback takes a snap, pitches, and there's a reverse. And he gets to the outside along. He's got room to run, number 42. On the Panucci tracks him down, fights to a block, and brings him down. A game-saving tackle, or touchdown-saving tackle at the 50-yard line.
Yeah.
He was the only man out there that could make that play.
Yep. If he doesn't make it, we've got a one-score game.
We've got a penalty. Thrown late. I missed it, but it appeared the Rockets are cheering, so perhaps it was something late on Wilmington.
Unsportsmanlike.
Sportsmanlike conduct on Wilmington. That's going to move it back, what, 15 yards?
Yep.
Well, just my impression, Adam, I think this is the best officiating crew we've had for quite some time.
Absolutely,
they've got good control of this game.
Yeah, not a whole lot of flags. You know, just the obvious ones. Let the kids play.
Let the kids play. Good control of the game. And, you know, the down and distance, all those just basics, they seem to be doing a nice job. So that'd make it first and 10 for Wilmington from their 35. Can't say enough about Panucci fighting through that downfield block and making the tackle on that last play. High formation, got some motion. There's the sweep, number 7. He's out to the right, the left. He's dragged down there, he's pushed out of bounds. Number 54, Ben Mason was there, but I think the lead man was maybe Trevor Zupan. Well, that was a play where Wilmington's lucky to actually have gotten a yard or so out of that play. It could have been a disaster. Second and 9 from the 36. Wilmington goes trips left. And then there's the pass, the quick out. He's met immediately by Dan McGrath. Trevor Zupan joins in. I think they may have lost a yard on that one.
That one was almost picked.
Like, you see who flashed in?
I think it was Kajander. Looked like he may have flashed through.
Makes it 3rd and 10. Thomas Keene comes off. Right now in the A gaps, you got DeCrescenzo and Vinny Sullivan. No, I'm sorry. Well, yes. B gaps, you got BJ. There's the snap. He's going to throw. Almost picked off. The pass went short. There may have been some miscommunication because the receiver was trying to go long and he was trying to throw short. Dan McGrath was there to break it up, makes it 4th and 10.
It's a couple drop balls by Dan today. You wonder if the ribs may be playing a part of that. He's usually pretty sure-handed. Maybe Papa McGrath needs to get him some new gloves.
Fourth and 10. Looks like they're going for it. Down two scores. Snap is high. He's back to throw. He's on the move. He gets one up. Oh, oh. Beautiful catch by 84. He's still on his feet. Dan drags him down at the 23-yard line. A beautiful play and catch by number 84. The pass was just a touch high. He brought it down, was able to outrun the defense. So Wilmington, again, still alive in this football game. They've got some ball players on this team. First and 10 from the 24. In a do-or-die situation, that quarterback put it the only place he could, leading his receiver. Now in the I formation, under center, number 12. Motion by number 7. The pitch goes to the left, number 25. Brennan is under the block, but he's out there, and he gets all the way down for about a 20-yard pickup to the 5-yard line.
It's a couple times now we've lost containment on the ends, and it's really cost us.
That's right, not setting the edge. Coach is letting him know. First and goal for Wilmington. Timeout, Wilmington. First and goal for Wilmington midway through the third quarter. It's a snap. The counter handoff. He's met there after a gain of 1 by Dan McGrath. The rest of the Black Swarm pushes him back. Maybe got a yard. Second and goal. Seems like on that play, they never give it to the first man on the dive. It's always the counter. Second and 3. Second and goal from the 3. Number 7, a different quarterback. He hands it to the deep man. Ball's on the ground. There's a big pile there. Oh. Rockets ball. As they hold the line again. Who got it, Vinny Sullivan?
Trevor Zupan come out of there with that.
Zupan, all right. First down, Rockets. First and 10 from their own 3. Definitely need to get forward on this play. There's the snap. He carries it securely over the left-hand side. That's the sort of play you need on first down to get out from the shadow of your own end zone. Down to the 13. First down yardage. First and 10 Rockets from the 14. De Silva in the background, backfield with McGrath. There's the snap, rolls to his left. Dan makes a nice block on number 70, and Brennan's able to push forward to the 23-24, close to another first down. Followed his blocks really well. Dan made a nice block on the outside. First down again. So the first two plays from the 3, and are able to get pick up 2 first downs out to the 25. Evan Long joins McGrath in the backfield. Right wing is De Silva this time. There's the snap. Dan takes it. Busts through the middle. He's able to get right through the heart of the defense for 9 yards, close to another first down. It's the 34-yard line.
Looks like the end of the third quarter
there. End of the third quarter with the Rockets leading 16 to nothing with the ball moving on their own 34-yard line. As we start the fourth quarter, up 16 to nothing for the Rockets. They've got second and about a half a yard from their own 34. There's the snap to DeSilva over the right side. He busts through a hole and picks up 6 yards in the first down. He was covering that ball up as he was going through, making sure that he was holding on the ball. Good ball security. Such a smart, heady player.
Yeah.
Having him in charge of our offense, it's the right guy to captain the ship there.
Absolutely.
First and 10 from the 41. DeSilva and McGrath in the backfield. DeSilva takes it over the right-hand edge. He's got a little room on the side. A great opening, leading block by Dan McGrath. He's down the sideline. He steps out at the 37 after a first down yardage. Once he was able to turn it up, put on the Jets. First down Rockets. With the play call. On the right side, you got DeCrescenzo at guard, Kajander at tackle. There's a snap. Dan McGrath takes it over the left-hand side. He's got room to run. He gets past number 50. He makes a move. He carries three guys down to the 20-yard line. This is the crushing drive that we were talking about. This drive started on their own 3-yard line, and they're now down to the Wilmington 19. Right now what you see is Redding consistently getting to the outside and getting these long gainers.
Yep.
10 to 15 yards each. How about Chris Chuley today with the job he's doing snapping the ball?
Been on the numbers all day.
On point all day. There's the snap to Dan McGrath. He's going to throw. He's got it up. He's got a man. Oh, oh. Just outside the reach of Brendan DeSilva. I like the aggressiveness. Second down. Second and 10. McGrath and DeSilva in the backfield. There's Brendan DeSilva over the left-hand side. And he's brought down. Not much there as two Wilmington defenders came up to set the edge. Makes it third and probably about 11 or 12 from the 21.
You know, that they made the adjustment, pushing us to the outside.
They've seen that play a few times on this drive. The snap goes to McGrath. He runs up the middle down to about the 16-yard line. Bring up a fourth down and maybe call it seven. A few years for these boys, that would be a prime field goal opportunity. I think it's just a bit out of Christian Trauger's range at this point.
Yeah.
I wouldn't put it past him. In a year or two, it'd be automatic. momentum in this drive, letting that clock wind. Coach wants to get this call right. We got fourth down and 7. Timeout, Redding. He let that play clock wind down and then called timeout. Yeah. We're definitely going to preserve this lead.
Yeah, I think it was a good call on a couple fronts. You had run the time, and Evan Long had to come out for an injury, and he can't go back in. With a timeout, he has the opportunity to substitute back in. So we'll see if that was some of the mindset for that.
Fourth and 7. Coach has had time to put in a great play call. We've got the Rhino formation with DeSilva, McGrath, and Mason in the backfield. The snap goes to Ben Mason over the right-hand side. He's able to pick his way through the first man. A couple of guys meet him there, number 50. He's dragged out at the 12. He got 5 or 6 on the play, but it's going to be short of the first down. So Wilmington will take over. Looked like that was maybe going to make it, but Wilmington fought their way through and make the play. But still the drive, you have to consider it a success as they drove from the 3-yard line all the way down to the opposing 13. Ate up a lot of clock. Wilmington still 2 full scores behind, plus 2-point conversions. And we haven't even seen them touch the scoreboard yet. So now let's see if the Reading defense can capitalize and not let Wilmington move the ball. Filling the A gaps right now. We got Sullivan and Keen, 40 and 14. Keen's 40, Sullivan's 14. BJ and DeCrescenzo in the B gaps. There's a snap out of the shotgun. Number 12 throws it. Good coverage right there by Dan McGrath.
Oh,
they're going to call a flag. Oh. I don't know. He was going for the same ball as number 50, unless it was, you know, impeded him to the stop, to the spot. Excuse me.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they've got pass interference on McGrath, but, you know, pretty good coverage for what we've seen.
Talk about the good officiating. They may have ruined the whole experience for me right there.
Chris Shuley comes on for Vinny Sullivan in the A-gap. Let's get a little pressure up the middle here. Number 12 in the backfield in the shotgun formation. He's back to pass. He gets it up out of the reach of number 7 with DeSilva in coverage. Second down. There's a snap. Chuley offside.
He's got a free play.
Free play. Throws it up deep. Out of the reach of number 7. Had the distance, but not the accuracy on that throw. But I think he had a free play, like you say. Well, Rockets don't need to be giving them extra yards here on penalties. Make them earn it.
Yep.
2nd and 5.
Been a little jumpy on that line all day.
Snap, back to throw. The ball is knocked down by Dan McGrath as he closed on the pass out there to number 50. Mason was in coverage too. I like that our defense is getting to work against a passing offense.
Yeah.
The more we see of it, the better the coverage is that, you know, as the game goes on. The better the coverage. 3rd down and 5 from the 33. This time it's an I formation with quarterback under center. There's the pitch. Oh, number 42 on an end around. He's got room. He is on his horse. He's met down there and brought down by Trevor Zupan. Is that Zupan? No, it was, Trevor Zupan with the tackle at the 30-yard line. That play was almost blown up in the backfield before it got started, but once he got outside Jared Pinucci, he was gone.
I think that's where some of our aggressiveness may hurt us, over pursuit.
First and 10, Wilmington from the 30. They've moved it some today on the Rockets, but without being able to score. I formation again. There's the same play going the other direction. And not this time. B.J. Gemmellaro on the tackle, assisted by Dom DiCrescenzo.
BJ,
I don't think he even made it back to the line of scrimmage.
Did a good job of cutting off the end, making him cut inside.
That's right. Well, in that instance, they weren't going to be fooled twice.
No.
Second and 11. Trips right formation for Wilmington. Quarterback under center. We got jump on the line. Who moved? I saw Matt Gorman flash across, but he may have been drawn off. There we go. False start on Wilmington. Makes it second and 16. Second and 16, Wilmington comes out in the same formation with three receivers to the right, one back in the backfield, quarterback under center. He takes a snap, he rolls to his right. He's got a man, number 33, on the out route, met there by Brendan DeSilva. Still on his feet, and he gets first down yardage. He fights over the 20-yard line. Way to shake off that initial tackle. And Wilmington has a first down at the 18. Here we go. Wilmington's got the ball, first and 10 from their own, from the 19 of Reading. Pitch left, and he's met.
Oh.
B.J. Gemmellaro burst through, and a 10-yard loss on the play, the 30-yard line.
He's been so close to that two or three times today.
That's right. Burst right through the block and met him immediately upon receiving the pitch. Makes it second and long. Second and 17. Shotgun, back to pass number 12. He's got a man on the outside, number 7. Makes a move and gets away from the first man. He's brought down after a successful play, a pickup about 10 on the play. They've got the timing on those out routes today.
Yeah.
Third down and 5. Timeout for Wilmington. No?
Brendan went back in.
Okay, Brendan DeSilva's back in the game. Christian Chauger comes off. Third and 5. Evan Long and B.J. Gemmellaro are wide. Back to pass. It's out of play. In coverage was Brendan DeSilva. You know, makes it fourth down.
They keep running that out route. I'd like to see one of these
guys.
Had
a lot of success on it.
Cut under it or jump it.
As a cornerback, there's nothing better than picking up one of those out routes and going the other direction.
Yeah.
Clock says 3.5 minutes. Score is still 16-0. Been a hard-fought game today. Quarterback's under center right now with three receivers wide right. Comes down to this here with 4th and 6. And he hands off to the deep back who busts over the left side. He's brought down by Dan McGrath just short of the goal line, assisted by Ben Mason. Picked up the first down yardage, and they're in position to try and score here. They ran over left tackle with all the receivers spread out to the right. Time to be stout on that line. Gorman and Chuli in the A gaps. Kajander and Ben Mason. BJ Gemellaro, Dom DiCrescenzo along the line. Strength upon strength. Let's see who can get the push. 12's under center. He bursts in with the QB sneaker. Makes it 16-6. Wilmington's finally on the board with just over 3 minutes remaining in the game. Much like the Patriots. Is there a flag?
Yeah. Looks like a little extracurricular after the play. I'm not sure who it was on, though. Unsportsmanlike. These are the penalties you can't have right now.
Yeah.
Because if this is against Reading, they enforce it on the kickoff, which it is against Reading.
Yeah, unsportsmanlike against Reading. Well, coach will need to clean up some of those discipline sort of things before next week. It was a key moment here, up 10 points, Wilmington going for the two-point conversion. If they can do that, they remain only one score down. But if they don't convert, then Reading stays two scores up. That kick is up. It is a good-looking kick.
That's good.
It is through. So 16-8 is the score. Expect the onside kick here with just over 3 minutes remaining in the game. Reading needs to keep their composure right here, get their hands team out there. With the unsportsmanlike conduct on the Wilmington touchdown, it's been assessed on the kickoff, so they're kicking off from the 45-yard line rather than their own 40. So the Rockets... The line to defend here is their own 35 as they prepare for the likely onside kick. Should they not get this, Wilmington's in good position to strike again. Number 7 here to kick off. There it is. It's in the, and it's covered up by the Reading Rockets. Nice coverage on the onside kick attempt. They take over at the 31. They need to salt this game away with a good drive, good long drive. Keep it on the ground. First and 10, Reading Rockets. Brennan DeSilva, Dan McGrath in the backfield. Brennan takes the ball over right tackle. He is face masked, but they didn't call it. He gets down over the 36-yard line. About a 5-yard carry. You saw that, right?
Yeah.
Second and 5.
Good to see he's got both hands on the ball, though.
That's right.
A face mask like that can easily jar it loose.
They just got to hang on to the ball right here. 4 or 5 yards of the clip and not fumble is the key. Chuli centering the line. The snap to Brennan DeSilva over the left-hand side. He plunges forward for 4 yards on that carry. Close to first down yardage. Solid blocking right now. And he's got the first down. No?
He signaled first down.
Half a yard as they come up to the line. There's the snap. Brennan fights through the initial tackle, plunges forward. It looks like he's got first down. Yardage, depending on where they spot the ball. Not a great spot.
Oh.
They're going to bring the chains out to measure. They stop the clock here to measure. I don't think he got it.
Yeah, it looks like he may be.
Oh, he got it. Oh. First down. That is a key first down. It gives us the chance to run at least three more plays.
Yep.
Burn that clock. I don't know if Wilmington's called any of their timeouts yet. Right now, under center, Brennan De Silva. Looks like he's going to take the victory formation. Takes a knee. Coach must know how much is left on the clock if he's taking the knee already.
Like it's it.
Ball game. Reading Rockets with a 16-8 victory over a tough Wilmington squad. Touchdowns on the day went to Ben Mason on a carry in the first quarter and an interception yard, 80-yard interception return by Evan Long. After that, they held on to the lead with some timely defense and just enough offense. So they won the turnover battle today and played excellent special teams. And did just enough to win. So with that win, Reading advances to the playoffs next week.
Right. You know, the Wilmington team was a much better team than we probably thought coming into today.
Yeah, they definitely had some ball players.
Well coached. But
I'd like to know what their record was. From what we hear, they only lost to Everett by one score, right?
Right. And been in every game they've been in, it's been a close game. So.
Yeah.
It was a good win today.
Yeah, a good test. And, you know, the boys having been off for a week, they really needed to, you know, work out some kinks and be tested. So I'm sure Coach has have a great week of practice as they get ready for the playoffs next week. But congratulations to the Reading Rockets for advancing to the playoffs and playing a good, solid game today. Thanks for watching this game, and we'll see you next week.